So the basic idea is, when you are going to catch a bug with your net, make a really good stab at it. And once you've done that, flip your net over so that the bug can't get out. It looks kind of like this. I'm going to pretend at this point that there's an imaginary bug on the end of this plant right here. What you want to do is you take your net, come up nice and stealthy like, and go for it. Swing your net back and forth a couple times and flip it over. Now let's go catch ourselves a real bug. And there you go, it's that easy. We can now take a very close look at, in my case, a Gulf fritillary. So it's probably also worth talking about how to get a bug out of your net. The good news is we've caught a butterfly, and butterflies aren't particularly known for wanting to hurt the ends of fingers when you go and poke them inside of a net. There's other ways to deal with insects like bees or some insects that could actually deliver a bite or sting. We won't talk about those here today, but the basic idea of how to deal with this butterfly will be essentially the same. So what you don't want to do when trying to get a bug out of a net is just flip the net back over and look in. I'm doing it this way right now because I've still got the net clamped below. But if you just flip it over like this and take a look, you'll usually have an insect flying past your face. So if you have an insect, like a butterfly, feel free to actually just use your bare hand and go get it. The butterfly is not going to do you any damage. Leave the net as it was, with the net flipped over, and bring your hand in from the underside. This way, you can get to the insect without it actually flying away, and then you can just bring the bug out, and now you have it. Now let's say you don't have a butterfly. Let's say you have a bug that might potentially bite your finger, or it's a bug you don't know if it can bite your finger, or maybe it's a bee and you already know bees can sting your finger. If you want to get something like that out of your net, you want to use some kind of container. I brought a vial here, and I'm going to show you how to do it. Leaving the net in the same inverted position with the netting flipped over and the bug inside, take the lid off your container, hold it in your other hand, throw it on the ground, do anything you want with it, but with the vial and the open end, head into the net so that you can end up cupping the insect with the vial and having the net over the top. At this point, one of the easiest things to do is take the lid of the vial and put it over top of the vial, even with the netting in between. You don't actually have to clip it on, you can just hold it there. But now you can invert the net so that you can get the vial out. Once you have the insect inside the vial like this, you can just observe it, let it go. But if you want to keep it, take your free hand and put it back inside the net, getting the lid out. Doing this, you also keep the insect pressed against the netting so it still can't get out of the vial, and then bring the lid back over top of the vial, pulling the net gently out, and now you can clasp the lid and you have your insect. Thanks for watching. Be sure to check out some of our other videos, and happy bugging.